redeemed by the blood of his Son. Dear friends, I have longed to share my witness with you even from the depths of this prison cell. My days separated from the Lord are coming to an end, for he has shown me that I shall die soon. But before I leave you, I want to assure you one last time that the Son of God has come, the Messiah, our Savior and our King. Praise his name, for he was wounded for our transgressions, and by his stripes we are healed. This same Jesus who was crucified and rose again, this Jesus who was the Christ, Jesus the Christ, touching hearts and changing lives is why he came. Into a dark world a light appeared, and his name was Jesus. Wherever he went, there were crowds, so many of them looking for truth, and Jesus spoke. Then there were the sick and the hurting, so desperately needing to be healed, and Jesus touched them. But most of all, there were the ones with heavy hearts from carrying the guilt and shame of a lifetime, and Jesus forgave.
Like Forever, the day, the glory of the Lord.
feast of unleavened bread, which is called the Passover, was approaching, and the chief priests and scribes were seeking how they might put Jesus to death, for they were afraid of the people. And Satan entered into Judas Iscariot, one of the 12, and he went away and discussed with the chief priests and officers how he might deliver Jesus to them. And they were delighted and agreed to give him money, and he consented. And he began seeking a good opportunity to betray him. Then came the day of unleavened bread on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. And Jesus sent John and me, saying, "Go and prepare a place for us, that we may eat."
Other.
Is it I, Lord? Could it be me? Then Judas answered, Master, is it I? What you are about to do, do quickly. But none of us understood why Jesus said this to him. Then Judas went out. And after we had sung a hymn together, Jesus led several of us into a garden called Gethsemane. Sit here while I go over there and pray, he said to us. We could see that he was deeply distressed and troubled. My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow, even to the point of death. Stay here and keep watch. Then Jesus went away to pray, alone.
Oh, Gethsemane, beneath the stars, you embraced a lamb whose destiny was spoken long before the world began. In Gethsemane were his friends asleep as he knelt alone, praying, Father, take this cup, but knowing that it would be his
yours.
said, "Look, the hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of sinners."
Me. my life seems all in vain. I am longing for yesterday. My life seems all in vain, and I'm longing for yesterday.
Jesus was at last taken to Pontius Pilate, the Roman governor.
Get up! Bring it on!
struggle to let death have victory. Yet he willingly surrendered as he walked to Calvary. The road that led to Calvary was paved with drops of blood, and every step he made was an offering of love. And though he was a prisoner, he would set the captive free. He is Jesus, the sacrifice for me. Our grief and sorrow and the judgment of the grave. The holy righteous substitute for all the sin and shame. Yet he knew he would redeem the very ones that cursed his name. The road that led to Calvary was paved with drops of blood, and every step he made was an offering of love. And though he was a prisoner, he would set the captive free. He is Jesus, the sacrifice for me.
And prophets heard. then I saw him as a man. He made the blind to see.
His kingly head made for a crown, now crowned. with thorns, his kingly head crowned with thorns. Loving breast, his piercing eyes, now dark and blind, eyes of compassion warming the soul, fiery eyes burning at sin, tender eyes beckoning sinners, his piercing eyes, now dark and blind, his matchless voice, fountain of the Father's thoughts, stopped. Silence now, where once had flowed wisdom and comfort, spirit and life. His matchless voice stilled to speak no more. They took him down, his poor dead body, and prepared him for his burial.
Oh,
emotions had had enough of you. He didn't want to begin believing again in someone else's dream. And we couldn't blame him. For we haven't believed Mary either. We had had to see Jesus for ourselves. I guess there was a lump of doubt in all of us, along with some fear and weakness. You know, in a way, we are all Thomas.
We all are Thomas.
At the foot of his cross, for only there will you find his forgiveness, his
something that actually transpired nearly 2,000 years ago. And we ask the question, why did God do all of this? And the reason is because every man, woman, boy, and girl has a purpose in life. But there's a problem that keeps us from experiencing and fulfilling that purpose, and that problem is sin. And throughout the ages, man has tried many ways to eliminate sin. He's tried to live a good life. He's tried to be religious. But nothing would take care of that problem. So God culminated all of salvation history by sending his son Jesus to die on a cross. And when he died there, he was suspended between heaven and earth. And he paid the price for your sins and mine. And no matter who you are tonight, or why you're here, or where you're from, no matter what your station in life, God loves you, and tonight, he wants to forgive you of your sins. And it's not enough just to believe that with the head, but you have to come to a place where you invite him into your heart. The way that you do that is through a prayer. I'm going to ask us to bow our heads now, and if you would like to invite Christ into your heart, if you've never done that before, and you would like to do it, right where you sit, you can just pray in your heart. Or you may want to pray out loud as someone did last night. Just pray this prayer to God. Oh Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. And I know that you did die on a cross for me. Right now I want to turn from my sins. And I want to give you my heart. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Save me from my sins. Forgive me. And fill me with your love. And your power. Father, thank you for bringing salvation to me tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. Our prayer is that tonight, if you don't know him, that you met him. And if you met him tonight for the first time, we would like to know about it so that we can give you some material and help you and pray for you. When you came in tonight, you were given a program. Also in that program, you were given a card that looks something like this. It's an envelope. And if you prayed the prayer tonight to receive Christ, if you would just fill out that card and where it says, tonight I prayed for the first time to receive Christ as my personal Savior, if you would just check that box and on your way out, just drop it in one of the buckets. Our men will be standing out there. We'd like to know about it. Perhaps there's another decision that you would like to make. There are several there recorded. We would like to know about those as well. Or some people say to me, Pastor, we sure would like to make a contribution. And that's really not important to us. But if it's important to you and you want to give, that's fine too. But the main thing is that we magnify and glorify the Lord Jesus and decide tonight that for the rest of our lives we're going to live for him. It's all because of a place called Calvary. Thank you.